Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, and in this video we will understand what is standard hydrogen electrode, which is also known as SHE. Now first we will start with the construction of SHE. Initially we take a vessel, and in this vessel we take 1 molar H plus ions. These H plus ions are not taken directly but are taken in the form of HCl, which is 1 molar, because when HCl gets decomposed into H plus ions and Cl minus ions, since HCl is present in 1 molar, therefore it will give 1 molar H plus ions. Now in this 1 molar of H plus ions, we dip a glass tube. This blue color glass tube is nothing but known as your glass jacket. To this glass jacket, we have an opening. In this opening, we insert H2 gas. And to this glass tube, one platinum wire is fixed. And further on, this platinum wire is connected to a platinum plate. Then this platinum plate is coated with platinum black. Now why platinum plate is taken? The job of the platinum plate is nothing but to adsorb H2 gas. There's a difference between adsorb and absorb. Here platinum plate is adsorbing H2 gas. Adsorb means all the H2 gas which is inserted through this inlet will go into the glass jacket and will get attracted on this platinum plate. And why have we coated this platinum plate with platinum black? Just to increase its surface area. So after all the H2 gas cover this complete platinum plate, what will happen is that the extra H2 gas will go into this H plus ion solution and will form bubbles. These bubbles then go out of the solution by evaporation. Further on, we will understand the properties of this reference electrode, which is our SHE. The first property of SHE is that it acts as both cathode and anode. Which means it can act as an anode also, and it can act as a cathode also when it is connected with another electrode. The second property is that the electrode potential is always fixed, that is zero, which means that the electrode potential of this hydrogen electrode is not zero, but it is considered to be zero, and the value, the electrode potential of other electrode which is connected to it is calculated with respect to SHE. Okay, SHE is arbitrarily considered to have zero electrode potential. Now, what are the use of these properties? We will understand one by one. Let's understand the first property. Suppose you have connected this to another electrode. Now, since SHE is acting as anode, if SHE is acting as anode, as we all know, at anode there is always oxidation taking place. And what is oxidation? Oxidation is nothing but loss of electrons. So who will lose electrons? We have a platinum plate over here, but this platinum plate is not going to react. The only job of this platinum plate is to adsorb all the H2 molecules on it. So who is going to react? H2 gas and H plus ions are the ones who are going to react in this electrode. Now since at anode there is oxidation, which means loss of electrons. So who will lose electron? H2 or H plus? H plus will not lose electrons because it already requires one electron to become neutral. So it is deficient of electrons. So here H2 will lose electron and get converted into H plus ions. Since each H2 will release one electron, therefore H2 will release two electrons and two H plus ions will be formed. Now suppose our SHE is acting as a cathode. So since it is acting as a cathode, we all know at cathode there is nothing but reduction taking place. Now what is reduction? Reduction is nothing but gain of electrons. So who is going to gain electrons? H2 or H plus? Obviously H plus, because it requires electrons. So this H plus ions which are in this solution will take electron and become neutral H. But since, as we all know, that H in its monoatomic state is never stable, it is always stable in a diatomic state, that is H2. So since here H2 is present, to stabilize this equation, two H plus ions will take two electrons and get converted into H2. Now let's understand what is the use of this second property. We have said that the potential, electrode potential of SHE is always zero, which means that according to the Nernst equation, E of a cell is nothing but equals to E of cathode minus E of anode. So suppose your SHE is acting as anode, then we just have to simply substitute the value of anode as 0 and you will get the value of E of a cathode by simply comparing with cell potential. So this is the job when it is acting as an anode, that is, we just have to substitute the electrode potential of SHE as 0 over here. Now what if it is acting as cathode? If it is acting as cathode, it is simple. We have to substitute the value as 0 minus E of an anode. And here, by comparing, you can easily get the value of E of an anode as negative of E cell. But this SHE has certain drawbacks. Now, what are these drawbacks? Let's understand one by one. First drawback it is that pure H2 digas is not available easily in nature. This H2 gas which we are inserting over here is not easily available in nature, and it is necessary to maintain the pressure of this H2 gas as one atmospheric pressure, which is not possible because there is deficient of H2 gas in nature. And the second property is that maintenance of H plus ions to 1 molar. As we all know that in this electrolytic solution, the H plus ions are maintained to be 1 molar only, because since there is inlet of these bubbles, that is, the extra H2 gas goes into this solution and forms bubble, and this bubble evaporate, then there is a possibility that H plus ions also react with the water, oxygen molecule in the air, and they also get form water and get evaporated. So therefore, maintaining H plus ion at continuous 1 molar is not that easy. One more point which I forgot to mention is that the temperature must always be 298 Kelvin, which is the standard temperature. Therefore, this is known as standard hydrogen electrode, because all the standard conditions are applied, that is 1 molar, 298 Kelvin, which is 25 degrees Celsius, and 1 atmospheric pressure. This standard hydrogen electrode is also known as normal hydrogen electrode. Okay, so guys, this was all about SHE. If you have liked this video, then do subscribe to the channel, comment below and share this video with your friends. And since this has certain drawbacks, we will try to overcome these drawbacks in the next electro reference electrode, which is our calomel electrode.